Hey there, viewers. Given the recent pandemic, people are more paranoid than ever about their health. How's your breathing been lately? Acute respiratory infections are the largest cause of infectious death among children and adults worldwide. This describes an infection that interferes with normal breathing. It can affect either your upper or lower respiratory systems. Symptoms can include anything from fevers to chest pains to change in your skin color. There are several causes of this infection. Can pneumonia be one? How about bronchitis? Wait. What's a rhinovirus, and how do I get it? We're talking all this and more. Number 1. Human rhinovirus. Have you ever heard of this? Human rhinovirus can be a deciding factor in whether or not you get a respiratory infection. I know it has a silly name, and no, it has nothing to do with growing a horn and morphing into a wild animal. This is something much more simple, and a lot scarier. Human rhinovirus refers to different causes of colds and infections which lead to complications in the respiratory system. One of these causes is sinusitis. This refers to an infection in the lining of the sinus. The important tissue along the lining will become inflamed and begin to swell, causing air blockage. This is a serious no-no for your sinus since it needs air to thrive. Another main cause related to human rhinovirus is something known as otitis media. I know, it sounds like a really exclusive tech channel on YouTube. But like the word rhinovirus, names can be deceiving. Otitis media actually is a bacterial infection that leads to buildup of fluid on the back of the eardrum. These types of infections contribute to rhinovirus, which ultimately lead to complications to upper and lower respiratory systems. If you feel any signs of an infection around your ear or nose, talk to a doctor and figure out your next move. Number 2. Asthma. Asthma is linked to acute respiratory infections. If you suffer from this breathing, you need to watch out. An estimated 1 in 13 people have asthma, and there's no cure. When your asthma acts up, it can trigger an upper respiratory infection. It hurts the lungs, causing inflammation. This results in your airway becoming freakishly narrow. Warning signs of an infection include things like the obvious shortness of breath. You also need to watch out for coughing, wheezing, and fatigue. Another big red flag is sinusitis, which does not work well with asthma. As the airways of your nasal cavity become blocked, this will make it a lot harder to take in air. If you feel like you need to see a doctor, don't hold your breath. Alright, bad pun. Do you find this video interesting so far? Make sure you subscribe to our channel. Remember to hit the like button and ring the notification bell to stay up to date on all of our great Bestie content. Number 3. Influenza. This one is extra scary. Influenza is a viral infection that attacks your respiratory system. Keep in mind, it's not the same as the regular flu. This refers to something that affects your stomach more than breathing. Influenza will wreak havoc on your nose, lungs, and throat. When a person gets influenza, some of the first symptoms are extreme weakness, nasal congestion, and sore throat. You'll also experience a lot of sweating, not to mention an awful headache. Now, if a fever is what follows, you've definitely got a problem. For the most part, influenza cases go away with time, but many folks aren't so lucky. Between the months of October 2019 and April 2020, there were an estimated 62,000 flu-related deaths in the US alone. This isn't even counting the 740,000 people who were hospitalized with flu-like symptoms. There are several different factors that play into the severity of influenza. Your age plays a significant role in these stats. Kids under 5 are especially vulnerable to influenza, as well as adults over 65. Pregnant women and nursing home patients are also at high risk. If you suffer from terrible breathing, your flu will trigger complications with asthma as well as both ear and sinus infections. Number 4. Pneumonia. This is the cause of lower respiratory infections. Pneumonia is nothing to take lightly. Much like influenza, this infection takes control of your lungs with the help of bacteria and fungi. The lungs fill with fluid, making you unable to properly breathe. Sometimes there's even pus. No thank you. This infection goes after people who are physically weak and vulnerable. Around the world, pneumonia is the leading cause of death among children under 5. But it's not just kids. Each year in the United States, over 1 million grown adults enter the hospital because of pneumonia. Out of that number, 50,000 don't make it. Pneumonia spreads large amounts of bacteria throughout your lungs. Something as mild as a cold can put you in contact with it. Symptoms of pneumonia include coughing, fever and trouble breathing. You'll also feel a terrible chill throughout your body. Your chances of getting pneumonia rely heavily on your pre-existing conditions. If you already suffer from lung disease, watch out for these symptoms. See a doctor if necessary. A weakened immune system due to underlying sickness will also increase your chances of pneumonia. This is where fungi comes in. Your inability to properly fight off infection allows the fungi to collect. Pneumonia sure is terrifying, but there's other lung infections that can affect your lower respiratory system. Let's talk about bronchitis. But before we continue, are you concerned with the overall state of your health? You should take a look at our new video about gluten. Yeah, I said it. Check out 6 damaging effects gluten has on your health. You'll never look at bread the same way again. Now, back to our list of 6 things that can cause you to have respiratory infections. Number 5, bronchitis. This is yet another lower respiratory infection to watch out for. Bronchitis is a type of chronic obstructive pulmonary disease. I know, a little too complicated. Let's just say COPD for short. With bronchitis, the lining of your bronchial tubes become inflamed. These tubes are important, as they can help carry air in and out of the lungs. The irritation in your respiratory system creates a strong buildup of mucus. As a result, oxygen won't be able to come in and carbon dioxide won't be able to come out. Bronchitis is actually very common. In 2016, almost 9 million Americans were diagnosed with the disease. About 75% of those cases involved people over 45 years old. Different signs of bronchitis include the usual cough and chest pains, along with lots of mucus. With chronic bronchitis, your cough can last up to 3 months. Bouts of the disease can occur for another 2 years. Risk factors for bronchitis include cigarette smoke. People who smoke on the regular are at a much higher risk for developing bronchitis than those who are smoke-free. People with gastric reflux, as well as those exposed to toxic chemicals in the workplace, should also be taken into account. People over the age of 40 are especially vulnerable to getting bronchitis, so if you feel symptoms coming on, figure out your next course of action. Number 6. Bronchiolitis. I know, they sound the same, but there's actually a difference. Bronchiolitis hurts your lower respiratory system. This affects the bronchioles, which are a smaller airway into your lungs. Their job is to control your airflow. When your bronchioles are affected, they get inflamed and become narrow. This allows less oxygen to come in. Bronchiolitis can hurt both young children and adults. It's most common in children younger than 2 years. Around the world, bronchiolitis has been reported in up to 15% of children within the first year of life, particularly among those who are born prematurely. However, you still need to be cautious. Even if you aren't an infant, patients with chronic lung disease and heart issues need to take special care. These conditions are also listed as heavy risk factors. Bronchiolitis is a seasonal disorder most common around the fall and winter months. When a person is going through bronchiolitis, they'll notice more mucus production than usual. It'll also be much harder for you to breathe, since you aren't bringing in a lot of oxygen. One of the scarier things people will experience when suffering from this infection is a change in skin complexion. Bronchiolitis patients will notice a bluish tint in their skin. This is due to the lack of oxygen your skin's receiving. If you have a family history of this disease, see a doctor ASAP. They'll diagnose you and outline whatever treatment you'll need to go forward. Have you suffered from lung infections? How about asthma? Do you know someone with bronchiolitis? Let us know in the comments below. We'd love to hear from you.
Enjoyed this video? Hit like, share, and subscribe to Bestie. Wait, what kind of bestie would we be if we didn't tell you about our other awesome videos? Go ahead, choose the left or right video and enjoy.